The story of the Mickelson Trail is far from over, so it's not really possible to say how things turned out. It is possible to ask whether or not at this point the trail has lived up to its promise.
I think it has, and I think it has exceeded a lot of people's expectations as to what they thought it was going to be originally. Conservatively speaking, as far as annual trail use during the summer months, we look at about 60,000 during the summer, and that's conservative.
Trail backers said it would provide a boost to existing businesses. Frontier Photo has been thriving in Custer for over 20 years. They started renting bikes just a few years ago as a service to tourists.
And to get them in the store. Okay, now it works full circle. I get people in here and they look around and they say, oh, you rent bicycles. So it's kind of a full circle thing. But yes, we would be fine. It's just a supplement to our business.
The trail was also supposed to attract new businesses, and it has. Joey and Eddie Bonds owned a bike shop in Arizona, but about 10 years ago, they bought a bike shop in Hill City.
For us, it's the thing. That's it. We cater to the Mickelson Trail. I mean, that's 99% of our business is on the trail.
And if it wasn't here, we probably would have ended up either in Moab, Utah, or Bridgeport, California, because we were looking for a second location regardless.
The Mickelson Trail was supposed to improve the quality of life in Black Hills communities.
The Mickelson Trail adds a lot to Custer. It cuts right through town and gives people opportunities within town for nice places to walk, safe places to walk their dog or get some exercise, and it brings a lot of visitors to Custer.
The trail was also going to be a four-season attraction, and it is. Game Fish and Parks facilitate snowshoe hikes and other activities. A winter carnival in Lead features dog sled rides. And the Mickelson connects Deadwood and Lead to the Greater Black Hills snowmobile trail system farther south. Winter is the only time, and this section is the only portion of the Mickelson Trail ever open to motor vehicles.
The convenience is to be able to drive the trails and then be able to come in to and from the motels in town, because otherwise you'd have to load and haul them, and it's quite inconvenient.
As for the vandalism, theft, and privacy issues landowners adjacent to the trail worried about,
that of course hasn't proved to be an issue. It's just not. Bikers and hikers that are out in the outdoors are clean, friendly. They're responsible people that are going to take care of the trail.
They pick up after themselves. There's very, very little graffiti anywhere along the trail. We have very, very little vandalism. We actually have people call us and tell us when there's issues on the trail, or if they see something that they don't like, they will call us and tell us so that we can get out there right away and fix whatever problem there is.